Hey everyone, my name is Peter McCarron. I'm with the LaunchDarkly developer relations team, and today we're going to talk about Terraform Cloud and LaunchDarkly. You know, one of the goals that we've had with LaunchDarkly is to create a very user-friendly UI that allows you to do a lot of the feature management tasks that you want by logging into the portal directly. However, as things have changed, we know that users are starting to do a lot more with configuring things as code. And so what we did is we created the LaunchDarkly Terraform provider to allow users to be able to integrate LaunchDarkly into their Terraform configurations. We're going to talk about using Terraform Cloud with the Terraform LaunchDarkly provider to be able to create projects, environments, as well as creating and managing flags. If you're not familiar with Terraform Cloud, it's the hosted version of Terraform provided by HashiCorp, offers a series of collaboration and governance capabilities. So if you have a team of users who are going to be interacting with your Terraform environment, this might be a good place to start. Some of the key features that are added here is we have a remote state storage capability to protect our sensitive state files, as well as things like version control so we can integrate it into GitHub, which is what we're going to do today. So to get started, what we would do is we'd create a new workspace. In here, you'll see that you just click create new workspace and you walk through the step flow to be able to integrate it with any other repositories in whatever version control system you're using. So in my case, I'm using GitHub. What I've done is I've gone ahead and authorized Terraform Cloud to retrieve repository information from GitHub. Follow the steps in here to be able to connect it if you haven't done so already. But we've already gone ahead and hooked this up. So we have this workspace where we have Terraform LD demo. If I open this up here, you'll notice that we have a link out to the repository that we're working out of, and it's going to show us our latest run. I've done a couple of demos on here, so it's showing my latest one, which was destroying the run, but we're going to go ahead and kick off a new one in order to show what happens. So if I flip over to Terraform code, let's see exactly what we're building. So we're here in our Terraform code. If you're not familiar with Terraform, the way that it works is that you define a series of resources that Terraform is then going to interact with the corresponding API to build those resources for you. In the case of LaunchDarkly, we have the ability to create and specify resources like projects, environments, segments, as well as our flags. This is a single file that I'm doing this in. The larger deployments, if you're going to be doing a very complex project or multiple projects, you may want to break these out into multiple files so you can keep track of them. And if you make iterations or changes to one of those projects or to one of those flags, it doesn't affect the rest of your configuration. Just a good best practice as it starts to grow. So, but in my case, I'm just doing a very simple deployment. So we have ld.tf. The way Terraform operates is that you define the resource that you want to do. So in this case, we're going to build a LaunchDarkly project, and then we're going to name it TFC demo project. Then in there, I give it the different specifications, including the key that I'm going to need for things like my segments or for my environments. And then also I can determine if I want to have things like client-side availability. In my case, I'm going to be showing a React application here. So I want to make sure that this is set up to work with the JavaScript SDK on the client side. I also have disabled the mobile key because we're not doing any mobile development. From there, what I'm doing is I'm creating a series of flags. So I can create different variations, including Booleans, which I can then give different names and descriptions to. I also have the capability of doing string flags, so I can define different values. And last but not least, I can create a segment. So maybe I also want to add Brian to this segment. And we'll save our file. And what we're going to do is we're going to push this change to our GitHub account, and then we'll flip back over to our Terraform Cloud to show that interaction with the version control system. So we updated segment, commit and push. And if we go back over to our Terraform Cloud account, you'll notice here in a second that it's going to trigger a new run and it's going to have the same description that we've done. So what this is doing is that it's listening to any changes that happen on the repository we have here. You'll notice this updated, it says, hey, we updated segment, which was the commit message that I put in here. If we see the details, what this is going to do is it's going to tell us what the change is. Because I previously destroyed this run, this is creating everything from scratch. So there are five resources that we want to create here. And that includes our feature flags, three feature flags, as well as our project and our segment. So if this all looks good, I can go ahead and confirm and apply. Say we're ready to demo. Confirm our plan. The apply is going to pend here in a moment. And what this is going to do is it's going to tell us when it started and when it's created. As you notice, this was very fast because it's a very small project that we're creating. Now we can go over to our LaunchDarkly account and we can get started interacting with our application. So now we're in our LaunchDarkly account If I open up my projects, you'll notice I now have this Terraform Cloud demo and this testing environment. This matches the color definition that we had in our file. You'll also remember that we have our three flags that we created. We have our Boolean flag, which is our login components. We have our text color flag, as well as a background image flag. Now, one of the things that you're going to want to make sure you do is you're going to want to add these different tags. You'll notice that I have these Terraform manage tags. This is good just from an organizational standpoint, and it's also going to help you prevent something that's called drift. Drift is essentially when the Terraform state file doesn't match what the existing state of the environment is. So if I went in here in the UI and I created a bunch of different flags, it might confuse Terraform because there are flags that it doesn't expect because they don't exist in the state file. In that case, if I ran a different plan, I might wipe out some of those flags. So just a good practice to make sure that you're adding in these Terraform manage tags. And if you see ones that are in there that don't have those tags, there's probably something going on where either somebody isn't using Terraform or they're adding different information. And you just want to make sure that you can reconcile that. The other piece that you want to make sure that you do is that you, whenever you create a new project, you're likely developing that code outside of the project. So in this case, because I've created it, my code doesn't have any way of actually connecting to LaunchDarkly yet. So fortunately, I can use my handy command K here, copy my SDK key, get my client-side key, and connect it to my application. So I went ahead and did that. And now what we're looking at is we have our basic React application where we're showing our gray text. These are our defaults that we set up. If we go back into our segments, you'll notice that we also created that development team segment. So everything is working great. We're able to test out our flags normally. Maybe we use this and we find that, okay, we figured out our best combination. We're ready to push that code out. We no longer need this project. One of the benefits of doing this with Terraform is it becomes very easy to clean up your project afterwards. If I go back into my Terraform Cloud workspace, I can go into my settings and I can trigger what's called a destroy plan. Now, you don't need to always run a destroy plan every single time. Best practice is that if you're no longer going to be using the LaunchDarkly project, maybe you want to just clean it up. That's a good opportunity to do it. But the one thing you want to make sure is that you definitely are no longer going to use that project for development in that application. Because when we run a destroy, it destroys everything. So that project will be gone. It's not recoverable. Really important that you are very deliberate about this practice. Because we know that we've already got to switch everything over, we don't need this anymore. We can confirm and comply. Demo is finished. Confirm our plan, and it's going to go ahead and destroy those resources. So one of the things that'll happen, you'll notice that we're on our page here. Once this trigger finishes, and I try to go to the feature flags, we're going to get an error message saying, hey, this doesn't actually exist anymore. So if I sign back into my account, oops, looks like it's not there. I can return home and I go back to my default project. So the project's been removed. We no longer have access to those flags. So again, you just want to be deliberate about when you use a Terraform destroy. It's great for instances like this where we're doing a demo and we just want to clean up after ourselves. But if you're going to have long-lived flags or permanent flags, make sure that you're very careful with using that destroy because it will destroy all of those resources. Better practice is just to update your Terraform file, rerun it. Terraform will detect any changes in the resources and it will just destroy those resources instead of destroying everything. So if you like what you see and you're curious about how you can get started, make sure you go to the Terraform registry and read up on the LaunchDarkly provider. It has information about all the different resources that can get that you can build, as well as going to terraform.io to create your Terraform Cloud account. Thanks for watching.